Invoke 6 is our biggest release this year. We've rethought the UI so you can paint, draw, or say exactly what you want, where you want it. Keep what you love and change what you don't. In Invoke 6, you'll find dozens of new ways to get studio-grade control on our AI canvas. Export all of your canvas layers to a single Photoshop PSD file. Edit your images with simple prompt instructions with Flux Kontext Dev. Expand your prompts based on your selected model, and turn your images into text prompts in a single click. There's a lot to cover, so stick around.
Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about Invoke 6.0. It offers a number of new changes that make it easier than ever to use, and we've added some new features that I think y'all will be excited about. Let's cover what's changed. The first thing that we'll talk about is the addition of the Generate tab. In version 5.0 of the application, we unified everything into one canvas, which offered enhancements in generating images, but made it a lot harder to use for users that just wanted to get started with simple text generation. So we've brought back the Generate tab. We've also added Launchpads to each of the new tabs. Each Launchpad will include buttons and quick start items that'll allow you to get started on that tab. It'll also provide some helpful guidance on how that tab is intended to be used. Let's go ahead and pick a prompt template and generate an image. Beyond updates to the Generate tab, we recently updated the model selector to offer filters and a search bar, as well as the ability to review details and preview images. We've updated the LoRA menu to have this same capability, but we've also enhanced the visualization of related models that you configure inside your model manager. Related models will show a link icon indicating that you've created a relationship between that concept model or LoRA and the core model. You can also expand to see preview images that you've configured for your LoRAs directly in line in the selector. The Canvas Launchpad offers a number of options for getting started on the canvas. Any image that you bring into one of these items in the Launchpad will also resize the image appropriately for the canvas and the model that you have selected. If I were to take our image from before and bring that in as a layout image, that'll bring that in as a control layer for us to select the model and use on the canvas. Now, this one was a 1024 by 1024 image, so there was no resizing needed, but any large images that you bring in automatically resize to fit the canvas. So let's talk about a couple of other updates that we've made to the canvas for power users. Often when working on a very large canvas with a lot of controls, regional guidance, or anything else that might be an overlay inside of the tool, you've had to previously toggle on and off individual layers or sections. We've added a bulk hide for all of the non-raster layers, which you can toggle manually by hitting the hide non-raster layers button or use Shift H, which will hide all of your control layers, regional guidance layers, and anything else that's an overlay like a mask. This allows you to quickly peek and see what's underneath and then get back to working. We've also enhanced the bounding box to have a compositional guide based on feedback from one of our recent studio sessions. You can turn that on by going into the options and showing the rule of thirds guidelines. This will resize as you move it around so you can really see exactly what you want to do and how you might want to shape the image. You'll notice that the staging area now has an enhanced toolbar. We have previews of each of the images generated on the canvas for you to switch between. If I generate a number of images, I'll be able to see my entire queue and monitor progress. One major change to note is that global reference images are no longer used as a layer. It didn't really feel right for them to act as a layer when they didn't have any visual representation on the canvas. Instead, the reference image is now a section underneath the prompt itself. You'll notice that the negative prompt is something that you can toggle on or off, depending on whether you regularly change your negative prompt or whether you just use a prompt template that you've customized and use that for your negative prompting. You'll be able to see your reference image underneath your prompt section. You can drag images to it, and functionally, it will look and feel the same that reference images have in the past. On the canvas, you can always still bring in your bounding box to that reference image as well. Save this image and clear the canvas. One major new feature for the canvas is the ability to export all of your layers directly to a PSD file. On the raster layers section, you can click the export canvas to PSD. That'll take all of those raster layers, pull them into a PSD file, and allow you to open those up in Photoshop. It's a great way to continue taking the work that you've done on the canvas and finish out, polish it inside of your normal editing tool. For users of the hosted product, you've already had access to Flux Kontext Max and Flux Kontext Pro, which are excellent models and extremely good at editing images. With the release of Kontext Dev, Community Edition users now have access to this same capability. When using the Flux Kontext Dev model, you'll bring in an image as a reference image and type in a prompt that instructs it to make an edit. It's an instructive model, so you can say, make this image into a painting, turn this image into something else, add or remove objects from the image. It functions the same way as the Pro and Max model, but is run locally on your machine. Now, for Pro users in 6.0, we've added a major enhancement to the hosted product with the ability to automatically expand and generate prompts directly inside of the studio. We'll switch over to the hosted product to take a look. You'll notice that your prompt box now has an expand option. You can type in a basic prompt and have it expanded, or drag an image and generate a prompt from that. Depending on what model you have selected, for example, SDXL or Flux, the prompt will be formatted in a way that is aligned with how those models are typically prompted. So in this case, we've got our golden retriever, dog, canine, wet fur, so on and so forth. Once that prompt has been provided, we need to either accept it and replace our existing prompt or insert that in. In this case, because we started with nothing, either of these will do the same thing. So I'll just hit replace and that'll update my prompt box with the new prompt. There are a number of other smaller changes throughout the application that reduce friction on normal tasks that you have been navigating. We've got more changes on the way in an upcoming release that'll continue to add on to the interface. We're looking forward to seeing what your feedback is and what you do with the new version of the application. And as always, happy invoking.